What is up, Evil Dead fans? I have a special video coming to you right now. It was a discussion I had on the Ghost Beaters on Facebook with Robby, Kyle Anderson, and Kyle Brown about who owned the cabins, Evil Dead 1, Evil Dead 2. Now, this is going to be a two-part video. This one's going to center around Evil Dead 1. So let's get into it right now. So this subject came up in on Facebook on the Ghost Beaters page. Robby, Kyle Anderson, and Kyle Brown brought this up. They were talking about, and I was in this discussion of who owned the cabin, or, you know, to that aspect, what happened? Who owns it? To really get into it, we really need to start from square one with Evil Dead 1. And we're going to look at that as its own thing, not including Evil Dead 2. And looking into this, I figured out what happened to Professor Knowbey. Now, the consensus says that Professor Knowbey died either in the cabin, or there's a scene at the beginning when you see the evil force on the intro of the movie crosses this pond and you see a wrecked car in the pond, and everybody says, well, that's Professor Knowbey's car. So let's take a look at that right now. So there's the car, and the consensus say that that's where Knowbey died. That's a big theory right now. And I'm not saying that's not his car. It's a possibility that it might be his car. Another thing is, why was the book, the dagger, also the shotgun with an open box of shells in the cellar in the back? Why wouldn't he do all of his research upstairs? Let me show you the scene when it's in the cellar.
Look at all this stuff. I bet this still shoots.
Probably does.
Oh!
This kind of looks like your old girlfriend.
Come on, let's take this stuff upstairs. I'll grab the recorder, and you get everything else, yeah?
Okay, another thing we need to look at is, by the way, I got Evil Dead 1 still playing in the background, and it's the tree scene, so I'm not watching anything inappropriate. It's just Evil Dead 1. We also need to look at the first time they listened to the tape recorder, when they listened to the incantation, what Knowbey said about the cabin. So let's take a look at that.
This is the tape I found downstairs.
It has been a number of years since I began excavating the ruins of Kandar with a group of my colleagues. Now my wife and I have retreated to a small cabin in the solitude of these mountains. Here I continued my research undisturbed by the myriad distractions of modern society.
Okay, as you hear in that is him and Henrietta, his wife, Mrs. Knowbey, they retreated to a cabin in the woods, which he did not own. He did not own that piece of property. Now, leaves the other question. If he doesn't own the cabin in Evil Dead 1, wouldn't the owners of that cabin see what would happen as he pays rent and stuff like that? If you listen closely, he has been there for quite some time. Professor Knowbey has been there for quite some time. He could have done a year-long lease, something like that, or a two-year lease. And it could be known as the Knowbey Cabin because of how long he spent time there deciphering the book. It's not like he just got there and he's like, oh yeah, I figured this out right away. No, that kind of shit takes time. So he was there, him and his wife were there for quite some time. Now remember, we're sticking strictly to Evil Dead 1. So, he's written this cabin out. He has the book. And that's what happens. Then he reads from the book. And then it cuts to, well, let me just show you the next little step. So he's been there for quite some time, him and his wife. He's figuring the book out. And we need to listen to the second part of the recording that Ash listens to. So let's listen to that now.
I know now that my wife has become host to a Kandarian demon. I fear that the only way to stop those possessed by the spirits of the book is through the act of bodily dismemberment. I would leave now to avoid this horror, but for myself, I have seen the dark shadows moving in the woods, and I have no doubt that whatever I have resurrected through this book is sure to come calling for me.
Okay, so listening to that, that you hear Professor Knowbey say he's going to leave, and seeing the placement of the tape recorder, the dagger, in the book, is what happened is Henrietta turned into a dead. He takes everything, hides from her in the cellar. He's been there for a long time. He's not going to do everything in the farthest corner of the cellar. He took that down there with him. Him and Henrietta had a standoff. He chopped her up and buried her in the earthly floor of the cellar. Now, when it comes to the car in the swamp, there is a possibility that's more of hearsay, that that was his car. But he didn't die there. I'll say that right now. He did not die. He actually escaped. Now, why do I say that he escaped? Now, we need to look at the bridge. Why was it important for the evil force to take the bridge out? Why is that a big thing? Now, I had to go back and I had to really look in the original movie, short film that they did to promote people investing in the Evil Dead. I looked at Indian burial grounds, different religions, different facts, things like that. Running water is known for cleansing the soul, cleansing, baptism, things like that. Now, you can say, well, it ran across a swamp. That's a stagnant thing of water. It is not running water. Running water is known as clean water. It's cleansing. So if it could cross the bridge, it wouldn't need to take the bridge out. It wouldn't need to do that. It just wouldn't. It wouldn't have to do that. So there's a reason they fucked up with Professor Knowbey. They weren't going to fuck up a second time. It took the bridge out. Evil Dead 1 took it out. Evil Dead 2. We'll talk about that later. But you're saying, well, this is all hearsay, Brett. This is just your theory. To a point, it is my theory, but now I'm going to prove to you why Professor Knowbey survived. And we're going to listen to some dialogue that a lot of people ignore that is towards the beginning of the movie that comes from Scotty's mouth himself to prove that Professor Knowbey did, in fact, survive in the original Evil Dead movie. Here it is.
Hey, Scotty, what's this place like anyway?
Well, the guy that's renting it says it's an old place. A little run down, but it's right up in the mountains. And the best part is we get it so cheap.
Yeah, why are we getting it so cheap?
Well, I don't know. Might be in real bad shape.
You mean nobody's seen this place yet?
Well, not yet.
Well, it might not be that bad.
So there you have it, straight from the horse's mouth. Scotty himself said, the guy who is renting the cabin. Who is renting the cabin? It is Professor Knowbey. Now, you might say that, you know, somebody else could have rented the cabin, but one thing is we know is nothing crazy happened. Number two, how would Scotty know where the keys are at above the door? If Professor Knowbey, in theory, had a long lease on it, he would know exactly where those keys are at. And that's why Scotty knows where the keys are at. Also, it was rented very cheaply. So Professor Knowbey did, in fact, probably put an ad out there in the newspaper and, Scotty contacted him and that's what happened. Why would he do that to them? Two reasons. To see if the evil was still there and to use them as a guinea pig. Also, he probably wants the book and the dagger back. So let's wrap this up and go back to the beginning, to the end. First, Knowbey found the book, the dagger, and all that stuff. Him and his wife rented a cabin out in the woods, probably had long leases, so he's been there for quite some time, trying to figure out what the book says. Henrietta turns into a deadite. He takes all the shit, goes to the back of the cellar to hide from her. They have a standoff. The shotgun is sitting there on the table. He shoots her, figures out that he has to cut her up, cuts her up, buries her in the cellar, puts his last recording on, either before he kills Henrietta or after. Could be either or, because he says, you know, it probably has to be bodily dismemberment. He leaves everything there. Why does he leave everything there? He doesn't know what the evil force wants with the book. So he's not going to fuck with that. Cross the bridge, and also the evil force can't cross that bridge because of the running water, if you follow that theory. But it also, makes it a reason why the bridge had to be destroyed, because they can't leave. They can't cross that. Professor Knowbey puts out an ad. Scotty answers it. Scotty gets the rental cabin from Professor Knowbey at very, very cheap, inexpensive cost. So to end this off, we don't know who officially owns the cabin, an Evil Dead one, but we know Professor Knowbey now did in fact survive. I want to thank again Robby, Kyle Anderson, and Kyle Brown for this conversation on the Ghost Spears, Ash vs. Evil Dead on Facebook. If you're not on there, you should be. Also, the Knights of Samaria, both pages are two good pages for anything Evil Dead. So the next one will be Evil Dead 2. Stick around for that. Same theory, same kind of thing. And until next time, you guys stay groovy.